Good afternoon, and welcome to the American Bankers Association and Promontory MortgagePath Partner on the Line webinar, Banker Perspective, Transforming Your Mortgage Business Through Strategic Partnership. My name is Veronica Kelly, and I work in the Endorsed Solutions Group here at the ABA. We are excited to have our endorsed partner, Promontory MortgagePath, present today's webinar. Promontory MortgagePath combines a digital mortgage platform with comprehensive mortgage fulfillment services, giving community banks the technology and scalability required to compete in today's residential mortgage market. Promontory's mortgage fulfillment solutions address many of the factors making mortgage lending challenging for community banks, including a high fixed cost structure, compliance complexity, and volume volatility. By providing all the technology, including point of sale and loan origination systems, and the back office operational support required to manage the end-to-end mortgage processes, Promontory MortgagePath ensures their community bank partners can seamlessly and profitably offer mortgages as core products without supporting an entire mortgage operation. The program will begin in just a moment, but first, let's cover a few housekeeping items. The session is being recorded. All lines have been muted for the duration of the presentation, which will run approximately 40 minutes. If you have any questions, please send them using the Q&A panel on the left-hand side of your screen. In the next few days, a follow-up email with the link to this recording will be sent to all registrants. I am happy to be joined today by senior leaders from Promontory MortgagePath and Kitsap Bank, a community bank with more than 100 years history providing community banking services in the greater Puget Sound region, and a Promontory MortgagePath client. Charles Robertson is Senior Vice President and Chief Retail Officer at Kitsap Bank, and Adam Arnold is Chief Strategy Officer at Promontory MortgagePath. Thank you both for leading today's webinar and for our great partnership. Now, I'll turn the floor over to the Promontory team. Adam?
Thank you, Veronica. Thank you for the introduction. My thanks to everyone who is participating today and making time to talk about the digital mortgage future. I want to just take a minute go back to the origins of the ABA. Many of you may be familiar with this, but back in 1873, about 150 years ago, bankers came together in a forum like this to discuss the challenges of the Panic of 1873. And a lot of courage in those early days and those bankers and pioneers that were in that room. And that brings us forward to today. And the opportunity to share ideas and continue to drive that path forward together. So I also, in addition to thanking the ABA and the participants, I want to extend an especially warm thank you to Charles Robertson, the entire Kitsap Bank family. We've had a wonderful partnership and look forward to today's discussion. So to take one more moment, I want to take a minute at a very high level to introduce Promontory MortgagePath. Promontory MortgagePath is a technology end-to-end solution built in three core pillars: technology, compliance, and fulfillment. We are mission-driven and very focused on making sure that banks of all sizes, particularly community banks, regional banks, and other leadership financial institutions, have the support they need to reach all the way to the consumer that they want to serve, essentially to meet the consumer where they are at every point. So we'll spend some more time talking about all of this, but I want to pass it over to Charles Robertson.
Good morning, Adam, and I'm excited to talk about our partnership this morning. And good morning to all of the attendees, whether you're on the West Coast, the Midwest, or the East Coast, so depending upon where you are, good morning or good afternoon to all of you. Excited, before we get into a dialogue about our partnership, to talk a little bit about Kitsap Bank. And you can see from this slide, Kitsap Bank is headquartered in Port Orchard, Washington, and we've been around since 1908. That was our original bank headquarters on the corner of Bay Street and Port Orchard. As you can see in the middle picture, we're operating in five western Washington counties, and we're primarily to the west of Seattle up along the Puget Sound. We are excited to of our roots and as a family-owned bank, woman-owned bank for three generations. And we have 15 full-service branches and the largest fleet of interactive teller machines in western Washington, and now sit at a robust $1.7 billion in assets. Our core values at the bank on the next slide are rooted in our four pillars of local independence, meaningful relationships, community connections, and sustainable stewardship. And we have an amazing and talented group of Kitsap bankers that delivers and executes on these core values each and every day. On the next slide, we're proud to talk about our cause good commitment. And all of us at Kitsap Bank look to make a difference, no matter how small the deed or large the cause. And every day we're trying to positively impact the lives of our neighbors, coworkers, family, and friends. As you can see from some fun photos here, the team gets out and does a lot of good work in the community, and we're very proud of that. On the next slide, I'm sure y'all can appreciate, you know, as the environment today, like across the country, we have a market where the, particularly on the sales side or purchase inventory is not as as low, and home prices have risen more than 15%. On a year-over-year, on average, average sales price of homes in this market is over $700,000, and we are in one of the tightest housing markets in Western Washington, where more than 68% of the homes are selling over the asking price. So, lots of challenges and opportunities ahead. Certainly, with mortgage and where we are today, much like challenges we faced, as you referenced early on, Adam, back in the 1800s, and with the pandemic and with a rising rate environment, you know, lots for bankers to look after today, for sure, particularly in the community banking space. So that's a little bit about Kitsap Bank and our wonderful franchise and wonderful people that work here.
Charles, thank you. Thank you for sharing some of the Kitsap story. And again, thank you for the time that we spend together. Would you just share with the group or talk a little bit about what drove you to look for a strategic partner in mortgage and why MortgagePath?
Yeah, sure. You know, as we are we're a commercial bank, and we enjoy a large retail presence and a lot of retail clients that we interact with each and every day. And when we began thinking about kind of our past and what we've done in mortgage and with you know, the ever-changing mortgage environment, in 2018, when our board and our executive team thought about what can we do to be more scalable and deliver on a mortgage solution that we can provide to our clients that will stand the test of time. And at that time, we began to look at the opportunity to form a strategic partnership. And we had interacted you know, with Promontory in a prior, business function with CDARS, and you know, knew the good work in the history. And as we began to think about next steps and the ability to scale our mortgage solution, we started talking to Promontory MortgagePath in 2018, and found to have a good fit with our core values around meaningful relationships and opportunity to scale the mortgage business. And we decided to start having conversations, and ultimately our decision to work with Promontory at that time, it was unique and innovative around the sense that Promontory was just starting this new solution. And we really wanted to be part of the opportunity to help design it together. And that's where we were able to kick off and kind of transform where we are today. And it was a big part of our solution to be able to deliver a new and innovative channel to our clients through a digital channel that we had historically struggled with. So really for us, we want to, our CEO, Steve Politakis, and our executive team and senior leaders will always talk about, we want our clients to be able to bank the way that they want. And this has been a great pairing for us with a digital solution to pair with our branch network in particular. So we have a nice hybrid approach that our clients and prospects in the community can 24/7, 365, you know, put a mortgage application and look at some opportunities and tools and process that will then allow us to tie back that experience to one of our local bankers in the branches and help you with your mortgage solution. And the scalability of being able to have dedicated underwriters and processors to work along with our team allows us to focus more on what we do really good, is execute on having meaningful conversations with our clients.
So Charles, just echoing that sentiment, you know, for Promontory MortgagePath, when those conversations were taking place and we were really getting momentum together in 2018, early 2019, you all were a partner that had a strong dialogue with us. The best way for us to move everything forward that we worked on for the consumer was to have engagement between Steve Politakis, your CEO, and Gene Ludwig, our founder, to have other folks in leadership like you and me and other fabric across our leadership team spend time with each other. That's been key to stepping in and moving forward in a way that serves the consumer in the best way. One of the things that's similar in our organizations is the core value of meaningful relationships, and that's lived here between our coworkers and between our partnership. Talk a little bit more about, you know, the digital solution environment that's existed between the two of us. Really taking the client from where they are when they're coming into your branches to where they're starting online. We've had the ease and flexibility of doing both with you, being positioned for that.
Yeah, and you're absolutely right. I mean, it's the relationships. It's all about, it's really a relationship-driven solution where the opportunity for our clients in particular to have a, when we think about if we want to provide value, we want to make it as easy as possible for our clients to interact with us, and then really focus on the expertise that we can deliver and bridge a good solution for what their financial needs are. So the digital solution, where now today, you know, our clients can be invited to apply for a mortgage, or they may find, as they're searching out there for a partner on how they can engage in a mortgage solution, we're not looking for a transaction. We wanted to stand up a digital solution where we can really engage our clients, you know, deepen those relationships, and also acquire clients in our markets in which we serve, so we can engage with them as well. So when they have the opportunity to be introduced to someone in the branch, the local branch, and then invited to apply the solution, now they have the ease of having their mortgage application split up. They can, you know, load all their documents and have more flexibility on their time to do some of the work that it takes to manage through the mortgage application. And then our dedicated mortgage loan officers are able to partner with them, as well as the folks at Promontory, where there's a dedicated underwriter and processor that works with our originator and our client throughout that experience. But in all steps of the way, they're able to engage with us digitally, you know, saving them time, providing more value, and again, allowing us to focus more on the expertise of the banking relationship. That's a big play into what we want to be able to provide, you know, as a community bank, an innovative solution where clients are able to engage with us in a more efficient way, but ultimately be more impactful so we can focus on that relationship aspect of that partnership with our clients. And working with Promontory, you know, this is where from the very beginning, I would say that for us, it's been an exponential opportunity to not just focus on, you know, 1-4 family residential mortgages, but we also partnered with the Promontory team to think about our solution for all real estate secured products. So this is something that through the conversation and dialogue between Kitsap Bank and Promontory, where initially the solution was set up to be 1-4 family purchase and refinance opportunity, the Promontory team partnered with us and added to the cart of options, the ability for us to have our clients also apply and engage with the home equity line and loan solutions as well. So there's additional value there, and we continue to hear feedback from our clients as well as our employees that the experience now, again, allows them to focus more on what we do really well is have that meaningful conversation and provide expert advice.
I mean, that's that what Charles, what you just described is really, you know, the hallmark of what we've seen with Kitsap as a partner. You know, Promontory MortgagePath, you know, our organization has helped expand the good work that, you know, Kitsap is leading the way in their community with. And so where we're stepping in to add value is in technology. And then when you think about compliance, Kitsap is a leader and an excellent force in risk management and compliance needs for all their consumers and for the bank as a whole. But the Promontory compliance brand and history is a core of everything that we do and think about when we work through a mortgage solution. The other piece I just want to touch on that's really important is that the mortgage cycle certainly has some volatility in it. And using Promontory MortgagePath takes those responsibilities and shifts them to us as an organization. And we are staffed with teams that have tremendous mortgage experience, and it has essentially allowed Kitsap to just focus on what they do best, which is to be client-facing and coming up with more innovation and allowing us to have the special responsibility of completing a mortgage for a consumer, which for many consumers is for sure the hallmark of, you know, home ownership is the hallmark of families across the country. And it's the, in some cases, it's really the core of the beginning of a banking relationship that leads to deposits, business accounts, commercial credit, and vice versa. You know, we've had the opportunity to take clients that have been clients of Kitsap Bank for a long time with their commercial enterprise, with coming in and out of the branches as just a retail consumer, and broaden that to mortgage and continue to expand the Kitsap relationship, keep the customer all in one place. So it's a hallmark of what we've done together, and we're very appreciative and excited about it. Charles, if I could shift gears a little bit, the innovation and the pioneering spirit of the digital mortgage process, you know, talk a little bit about how, especially in your leadership role, talking to your retail leadership teams, you know, how you share the vision with them and how we share it with them together to help them grow those relationships.
Absolutely. Yeah. There's I want to just touch base on a couple of things you also said at the same time, where the innovation, the opportunity to provide, you know, particularly for a community bank, we want to be able to be, you know, competitive. And as we looked at our core values, the meaningful relationships and all the things that we do as a community bank will stand the test of time. But we need to be thoughtful about how we go to market and be competitive in the digital space. So again, allowing us to leverage our strengths and the ability to engage with our clients, the solution that we have partnered with Promontory on the digital experience is an impactful one. So for example, competing with, you know, the other fintech solutions out there where if, you know, mortgage brokers or where it's more of a transaction where we can do a mortgage at Kitsap Bank or for other community banks across the country, ends up being a 360 approach where if we help you with your mortgage, you know, it leads to other opportunities. And if you have your mortgage and you have primary checking accounts and direct deposit and, you know, the opportunity to partner with our commercial banking teams to do a phenomenal job at referring commercial clients over to our mortgage channel as well, only strengthens the opportunity to know that you can do your mortgage at your Kitsap Bank and not have to go through another fintech channel where it's become a very highly competitive space. And to your point earlier, around having the opportunity to scale is important for us because, you know, as we've outsourced some of the work, it doesn't by any means, we are responsible and accountable for all of the risk associated with doing mortgage lending under the umbrella of Kitsap Bank. So this is where, you know, we have a dedicated team that works and partners every day with the Promontory team that keeps keeps us going from a perspective of ensuring that there's good thought leadership. We're paying close attention to all of the compliance implications of doing mortgages, and that's been a nice opportunity for us because we have an amazing compliance team that partners with the Promontory team, and we're able to expand our knowledge of things that are, you know, on the roadmap, things that are changing in this environment. So the innovation part, you know, stands as an entry point where it does allow us to focus more on what we're really good at, meaningful relationships. But I would say that community banks, thinking about any partnership, you know, Promontory, other fintechs, there is still a lot of work involved with the day-to-day management of the relationship where I would never tell anyone it's all sunshine and roses. It's really around that partnership piece and making sure there's honest and open dialogue. And only when that occurs, then the innovation channel stands true on the things that we're trying to execute on. But it's really important just to, you know, emphasize that when you work with a strategic partner, there's still a lot of work that has to be done on a daily basis to manage the relationship. And when it's a healthy partnership, an open dialogue, again, that's where it really stands up to be a successful opportunity for both parties, but more importantly, for the clients that we serve.
Charles, to add to that or to emphasize that point, you know, the magic, while there are challenges with every relationship, with every partnership, but where the magic has happened here is it's not just a connection point between Charles and I, although you can hear from our discussion, we've spent a few years together, but it's the same conversation happening across our organizations with each other. So there's no spot in the dynamic where, you know, there's one controller in each institution, which is what you typically see in a vendor relationship, and in a partnership, which is what Promontory MortgagePath and Kitsap have together, which is what MortgagePath is building, you know, with every, you know, step or activity with Kitsap. It works because we've both invested in it, not at any one single point, but from our founder and the CEO of Kitsap, all the way through the organization, all our compliance folks know each other. The fulfillment teams are on pipeline calls, talking across the sales and client frontline relationships at Kitsap. So we have discussions where we are able to take the digital information, the data, and work arm in arm together. It's very unique, and it's a significant advancement in what the client's experiencing. The end consumer is not calling an 800 number. They're not looking at a website and wondering where to go. It's our solution, Promontory MortgagePath, is Kitsap's solution. It's white labeled on Kitsap's website so that everything can start with Kitsap and finish with Kitsap so that they can continue to grow those relationships and never have a single point between the Kitsap and Promontory relationship that would block up a dialogue that needs to be happening all the time at every level. It's a big investment from both organizations. And, you know, just to echo it again, Charles, my thanks for that, and my thanks to everyone on your team.
Yeah, and thank you, back. That's really the partnership. I think about, you know, for example, there's a lot happens on a, like I said, a day-to-day basis, and my colleague Matt Cover is working with his counterpart at Promontory each day to look through all of the things that come up and we need to be paying close attention to, and then sometimes have to shift. But I always appreciate one of the things that community banks really also have to be thinking about is the governance of, around third-party relationships, strategic relationships. And you know, we have an opportunity every month where we have Kitsap leaders and Promontory leaders get together, and we review our governance deck and SLAs, an opportunity to dig around the relationship, how things are going, take a temperature check, and if there's any need to redirect, we talk about those things, as well as thought leadership. And as we all can appreciate, particularly in the community banking space, having the data and analytics to continue to deliver on more innovative opportunities for our clients, that's been helpful to us, because with the borrower wallet experience, you know, we have a lot more data points now that we can look across the space and then make decisions on how we, you know, go to market and look at new opportunity and converting leads and different things that we get from a digital solution that, you know, we weren't able to see prior to leveraging a digital experience. I think that's important to call out, because it's information is key, and how you use the information is even more critical to make sure it's used in such a way where we're complementing our community bank model and that relationship-driven approach. So we're able to now work with our clients in a way where we have more information that only leads to more successful conversations we have with our clients every day.
I one of the other hallmarks of the relationship is so I'm in Washington, D.C. Charles is in Seattle, Washington. Promontory MortgagePath has office presence in, you know, Denver, Colorado, and Danbury, Connecticut, in Washington, D.C. And coming into what is a, you know, digital, decentralized environment, that was something that was very natural, the Promontory MortgagePath and Kitsap and our relationship. Sure, we've spent a lot of time with each other in many of the locations, but we were able to seamlessly keep going when, you know, the world shifted to a decentralized setup. Lots of resources backing each other up in different time zones, different locations, and that's from the communication, the relationship building, the spots where we have had bumps in the road, and Charles, Steve Maxwell, Matt Cover, leadership at Kitsap has been wonderful about being direct. So while we'll have group calls where we'll be talking through a particular loan level issue, the best part of the relationship is the opportunity, you know, in a regular cadence to get a call from Charles, get a call from Matt, or for me to call one of them shortly after a pipeline call and say, did you hear that the way I heard it? And should I go, do you want me to do something different with a member of our team? And oftentimes Matt or Charles will say to me, actually, Adam, we really liked that discussion, that spirited debate. And, you know, we're, you know, they've been very complimentary where a team member is having discussions back and forth. And again, they've been very direct when there's a challenge or a change we need to make. So I can't sort of celebrate that decentralized component of it, the ability to be flexible at different parts of the country at different times, having the path of data to look at together from the borrower wallet, from loan officer assist, has been a, you know, the technology is where it starts. But it's always people and a partnership.
Yeah, absolutely. And I would add on to that, you know, for our employees, as we all can appreciate in this current environment, actually yesterday, every month we have an all-bank call where our CEO and our senior leaders report out how the bank is doing and look to engage and inform our employee base to the best of of our abilities. And I think about yesterday we celebrated one of our employees in our IT group and just hit his 44-year anniversary with the bank yesterday. And I think about all of the employees that we have today and the employees that we'll acquire tomorrow. But engaging them as well as our clients is very important to us. So when we can deliver innovative solutions to our clients, but also make it easy for our employees to do business with our clients, and again, stay more in that client-facing expert role that we want them to play in helping people with their financial needs, giving them the tools to engage them as well as the opportunity to grow their careers. You know, so for us, the scalability is important because we don't, in a prior life where I worked at a larger institution where we enjoyed a low-rate environment for a while, that's changed. But when there's a lot of opportunity to do like refinance, and some organizations are brought on a lot of folks, and then later, if the changes may have to look differently about the human capital costs. However, for us, we're able to scale working with Promontory and optimize and provide more career opportunities for our retail teams who are heavy-handed in the mortgage space, supported by Matt and a couple of our sales coaches. But our branch managers and our financial services specialists or our personal bankers are able to help our clients with their residential mortgages, one to four family, purchase and refinance. So they add that to their buffet, making it a much more enriching experience for them, where they're doing everything they would do as a traditional retail banker. And now they're also able to help our clients with their mortgage needs, which is a critical part of the relationship, as we talked about. And then there's less handoff, but more of an opportunity to really build out a 360 relationship with our clients, and it becomes more meaningful for our employees as well as our customers.
Charles, in your leadership role, that career development for the client-facing teams that you have in all of your locations, in from the person who's greeting folks that are walking into the branch to the commercial lenders, to the branch managers, your ability to give a career path, an opportunity, an expansion of skills has been, right at the core, where we've stepped in and provided that specialty mortgage service so that you all focus on that. Could you talk a little bit more about, from that point, We've stepped in and had enough dialogue in those areas to know where you're going next. Will you talk a little bit about where you're going next? Because it's a real direct conversation we're always having with each other as we add, more technology and more capability to your scale.
Sure. We're always looking to build out our portfolio innovative solutions to support the core client and employee experience. So, for example, we've gotten out of the gate and have a group of core retail bankers that can also help our clients with mortgages, supported by, again, Matt Cover and his role and a couple of our sales coaches that work with the branch teams. And further evolving the offering in the mortgage space, and we're partnering right now and have been partnering on an all-in-one construction mortgage program, and look at other opportunities, particularly with the shift in rates and the opportunity to be focusing more on purchases where we can optimize that opportunity for us. It's a component of a bigger picture, right? So the things that we do, I think about it in giving the gift of time. Time is the most precious commodity for all of us. So giving the gift of time back to our clients and our bankers to have more meaningful conversations and leverage innovative digital channels, just like much like we have. The mortgage is one of them. Another one of them that I've talked about earlier in the conversation was our interactive teller service. So who would have thought, with the pandemic, of course, all of us as bankers are seeing a shift as clients engage with us more in a digital way. We've seen a huge spike in folks doing online mobile deposit, et cetera, through the pandemic. And having the digital mortgage opportunity has helped folks who are locked away at home. You know, they can apply for their mortgage loans and engage with us virtually and get the job done. So that's a big part of it. Is where we want to head to is continue to look for and partner with folks like Promontory. We can always make it easier for our clients to interact with us and give the tools to our teams to make them have them be as effective in their roles as they possibly can be. So there's a lot more to be done. The journey continues on through a strategic partnership and making sure that we're challenging each other to be thoughtful about what's next and how we can continue to engage in the stuff that we've rolled out on our buffet of options for our clients today and our employees as well.
So, Charles, thank you for sharing these ideas. Thank you for continuing to push back and forth with us in terms of our technology and innovation. You know, at this critical time for the consumers we serve, with interest rates moving higher, there is a lack of housing supply as we're feeling in communities across the country. The breadth of technology and partnership that we've built over these last few years has positioned Kitsap Bank and Promontory MortgagePath for success as the consumer really shifts into what is a more of a purchase market than a refinance market. Nobody can predict the cycle, but we're well positioned for this next chapter. When rates move in a different direction in the coming years, we'll shift up our teams to support your ever-growing client-facing teams.
Yeah, and that's where none of us as bankers would say it's not an easy business by any means, right? And it just gets more complicated over time. And when when us as bankers can leverage and unlock the thinking of others and around thought leadership and how can we keep delivering out an amazing client experience and have relevant and meaningful opportunities to engage with our clients. We need to continually challenge ourselves to think about how we can optimize and become more digital, but never ever lose sight of that we are in the people business and the meaningful relationships are core. And that's the most important thing as community bankers we all have to keep in mind. And as we compete with the larger organizations, that's where our competitive opportunity really lies. And it's neat now that we have so many opportunities out there, and it's just all around aligning with the right strategic partner and having a healthy relationship that has honest dialogue, again, because if it's for we've been around since 1908, we plan on being around for a long time. And as long as we work with strategic partners that share our core values and we can have those honest conversations, then we're in good space. And then continue to challenge us and each other and how we can do more and engage more. And this interest rate environment, it's always hard being a banker. I think this cycle is going to make it a little harder for all of us community bankers as the months and years persist with this interest rate environment. But we've stand the test of time and continue to dig in. But the more thought leadership and the honest conversation keeps it relevant and headed in the right direction.
So Charles and I would want to open it up to some questions and some dialogue from everybody that has taken time to participate with us today. We're appreciative and honored to have the opportunity to talk more and be responsive to questions. Veronica, do you want to take back over?
Sure. Thank you, Charles and Adam. We appreciate that. One of the questions, you mentioned establishing relationships at all levels in the organization. How many people at Kitsap support the mortgage process and Promontory relationship?
Great question. Thank you, Veronica. So we have several on our team that support the work. And again, I would just reiterate that when you work with a strategic partner and outsource some of the work, by no means do you outsource the risk and responsibility to ensure that the the product is what you would deliver if it was all done in-house. So we have a dedicated colleague. His name is Matt Cover. He's tasked with making sure that on a day-to-day basis, we're working with Promontory on things that may come up, and all of that leads into the monthly governance call, and where we talk about all of the SLAs, terms of agreements that have been achieved, and all of the tactical part of the relationship. And then behind that, we have a couple other folks that are working with our branch partners, residential sales coaches that work with the teams to continue to engage and train them on the mortgage experience, as well as they may originate deals that might be more complex that are outside the space of what a traditional retail banker might look at. And then in our loan operation team, we have several folks that support the work as well. And again, because we're doing mortgages in addition to home equity lines and loans through this channel, so we have a good core group of folks, several that partner with Promontory to make sure we get the job done from beginning to end.
So just to add to, sorry, Veronica, but just to add, it's an important question, and I just want to add to what Charles said, and that is the sales coaches from Kitsap that Charles was describing. It makes a huge, huge difference in the partnership as we're trying to, grow relationships with the consumer, with customers of Kitsap, to have all of that participation from the people that Charles just described on the line with the Promontory MortgagePath team. And from Promontory MortgagePath, you'll essentially find on the call, leads in the processing team, leads from the compliance teams, all dedicated to Kitsap and the Kitsap relationship, leads from our technology team, so that we can hear where product and innovation need to be added into the solution we're providing for Kitsap. So it is many people touching it, and it's what's helping both our organizations grow faster with a digital outcome.
Okay, thank you. Does Promontory have offshore operations, or is all of their mortgage staff in the U.S.?
So all of our mortgage staff is in the U.S. All of our Promontory mortgage path team is in the U.S. And so when you hear the word outsourcing, there is certainly a immediate thought in your mind that takes you to some sort of solution that is offshore. And those are very complementary resources. But in the case of Promontory MortgagePath, we wanted to have onshore everybody here in the U.S. support, because one of the things we really like to do is dig in and understand the local community that Kitsap and other banks that we serve across the country. It's easier to get in the fabric of the communities and the banks we serve by being completely onshore.
Okay.
I would just add on to that. That's an important component for us, because our clients, when they need to reach us, the front end is all digital, but then there is a lot of times where dialogue with our clients back and forth, and they may be talking to our loan originator, but there's times when they are reaching out and talking to the processor that's assigned to the mortgage loan or the home equity wider loan that's on the Promontory side. They're going to reach them across the, in our time zone across the country at the relevant times, and that's an important factor to us, that our clients can not only engage with us digitally, but they still can pick up the phone and talk to us when they need to.
Does MortgagePath manage the entire fulfillment process for Kitsap, including process and underwriting?
So Promontory MortgagePath is providing the processing, the underwriting, the closing, and that front end technology. But it's just like Charles just described. There's a really productive dynamic when Matt Cover or our senior processors are on the calls together reviewing pipeline, reviewing the digital information that's there, because it makes for an easy environment for a sales coach or Matt at Kitsap to say to our processor, you know, I see that, you know, you've received updated statements. I see that you've received a pay stub. I see that we're still waiting on any sort of updated financial item. You know, Kitsap will help guide, you know, whoever's closest to that client at that moment, or where the dynamic in the relationship is. Promontory Mortgage Path is absolutely going to step up and do all of it. But having that open dynamic makes it so any member of the Kitsap team can say, I'll grab that from the consumer and I'll put it back into the digital system, and vice versa. So we will do all of those things, but it's the partnership that's making those things successful.
That's right. And ultimately, we take our governance very seriously, and we manage the overall relationship, and we treat it as such that, you know, again, the strategic partnership, it'll be employees of Promontory, but with our core values of you know, family values, we engage with our Promontory partners just as if they were here working in Port Orchard, Washington. So if we reach out directly, we're ultimately responsible. We manage the relationship and partner on a day-to-day basis with the Promontory team to get the work done.
Great. That's a great segue into the next question. What would you say the biggest benefit of this partnership has been?
So I'll take that from the Kitsap Bank perspective, and Adam chime in here too. But the scalability, the ability to deliver a digital solution that's relevant and meaningful, to engage our clients and our employees, and then to have the ability to work with, you know, subject matter experts to make sure that we're able to look at the big picture of, again, you know, there's a lot of work managing the mortgage business. And we want to be able to be as agile as possible. And the scalability for us to work with dedicated underwriters and processors staffed against our team, again, allows us to go back and focus on delivering really good value to our clients and try to make it easy as possible for them to do business with us, and really tool up our employees to make sure they have they provide the best expert solution-driven advice that they can provide to our clients. So that scalability in the partnership, when you can work stack against our subject matter experts with the subject matter experts at Promontory, really comes true to life when you have a nice strategic partnership where you can scale.
Just to echo Charles's sentiment, you know, for our Promontory Mortgage Path team, the partnership for us has really meant that we're not just coming up with solutions and going looking for challenges. What the Kitsap relationship has meant to us, to Promontory, has been really an open dialogue about what Kitsap and its consumers need, so that the pieces of technology, the automation of some of our compliance items, the flow of how fulfillment is working in terms of loan product and turn times, it's all coming from the needs of the customer, coming from Kitsap, which is special. I mean, that's what a partnership is about, and that's what's making our digital mortgage solution a real winner for Kitsap and, you know, for the other customers we serve. But it's because of this partnership and that early willingness to be nimble, agile, and direct. So really important partnership.
Okay, I think that's all the questions we have for this afternoon. Thank you both. That concludes today's webinar. I would like to thank again the team at Promontory for their informative presentation and all of the attendees. We appreciate it. Have a great afternoon.
Thank you. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you. Thank you, Charles. Thanks, everyone.